A teen MS-13 gang member told a 15-year-old girl not to forget my name before she tortured and murdered her last year in Virginia, the killer admitted to cops. Venus Romero Iraheta, now 18, pleaded guilty this week to taking the life of Damaris Reyes Rivas 1 year ago. Iraheta faces life in prison. Prosecutors say Iraheta and other gang members lured Reyes Rivas to a park in Fairfax County, where she was beaten and stabbed 23 times. Iraheta discussed the brutal details with police officers in a recorded interview on February 14. The video was released on Wednesday, 2 days following her guilty plea. "I don't remember how many times I stabbed her in the stomach," Iraheta told police in Spanish, according to the interview obtained by Fox 5. "Was it a lot?" an officer asked her. 13. "Something like that," she responded. "Why 13? The officer asked. "I don't remember," she responded. "No, I think it was 12 here, pointing from her stomach, and the 13th was in here, pointing to her neck." Prosecutors believe the gang members were seeking payback for the murder of Iraheta's boyfriend Christian Sosa Rivas. Iraheta believed Reyes Rivas set him up to be killed. Damaris Reyes Rivas and Christian Sosa Rivas were not related. "I asked her if at any time she had something to do with Christian," Iraheta told cops, according to Fox 5. "She said yes. I said I'm not going to forgive you. I told her, I warned you not to mess with me. I told you not to mess with Christian. I told you to stay away from him or you would see what would happen. You don't play with me. So I hit her. I kept hitting her. Until they stopped me." Iraheta said before she killed Reyes Rivas, she told her, "You are going to remember me until the day we see each other in hell. Don't forget my name," she recalled telling her. "And I told her my full name." When asked if the murder bothered her, Iraheta said no, according to Fox 5. She also told cops she cut off the teen's tattoo. Iraheta is one of 10 people charged with the murder. She pleaded guilty to the murder on Monday, which was exactly 1 year after the slaying. "Some kids are prodigies at the violin and some kids are prodigies at violence," Fairfax County Commonwealth's attorney Ray Moru said Monday, according to NBC. "This is a prodigy at violence.